Hello, VC. Mark here. Welcome to Recent Final Finds number 45. It's been a couple weeks. I have a pretty good stack, so let's get going. Start off with some more Target clearance items. These are all holiday albums. I left them in the bin, hoping that they would get marked down again, which they all did. The first one is by Elvis Presley, the classic Christmas album. One of my favorite holiday songs of all time is on this album. Santa Claus is Back in Town. This is on opaque white vinyl. It was $5.39. Just filled with holiday classics. The next one was $5.99, Kelly Clarkson, When Christmas Comes Around. And this is on white vinyl, limited edition, whatever that means. It means nothing. Probably the most successful of those shows. I forgot the name. America's Got Talent, I think. Everybody's parents or grandparents had the original of this classic in their collection. Bing Crosby, Christmas Classics. Of course, White Christmas is on this one. This is on metallic silver vinyl. And this was $7.49, but well worth it. The last one is a Disney album, Jingle Bell Fun. This was $5.39, comes with a collectible poster. It's on translucent red vinyl. On the next two titles at my local record shop, first one is by Stanley Turrentine, Rough and Tumble. This is a mono pressing, Liberty pressing, Van Gelder cut. This was a timely purchase. The ensemble covers Walk On By, which is a Hal David, Burt Bacharach classic. Burt just passed away at 94. Just a great, great songwriter. Really sophisticated pop songs. So many classics. They do a number of contemporary songs from back in the day. Shake by Sam Cooke. Let's see, Feeling Good. Just a great ensemble on this album. Blue Mitchell on trumpet. McCoy Tyner piano. Grant Green guitar. Bob Crenshaw bass. Really enjoyable listen. Excited to find this one. I did have a copy of this. It did not have the rap sheet. This is Kings of Rap, and this collects just a bunch of classic early artists. Fat Boys, Roxanne with UTFO, Gifted, The Fat Boys, Houdini. Really fun album. Really brings me back. And the best part, this one had the rap sheet. Lyrics, of course. Super clean. Pretty much flawless.
Just got rich and just froze, singing to myself how fast money goes. It took no call for me to collect it, but it didn't take long at all to wreck it. $50 tickets, a suit made leper, a goose down bummer to wear in cold weather. Freezed in my pocket, couldn't pay for fast spit. All my money to buy. Yeah.
the next few albums at the Goodwill, all of them 99 cents. The Monkees. I see this all the time. It's usually trashed. Either the jacket has lots of ring wear, but most of the time the vinyl is just scratched to hell. This is a super clean copy. Really not my cup of tea, but I will sell this one at the next record show. The next one's by Tom Rush, Take a Little Walk With Me. Covers a bunch of rock and roll classics. Really enjoyed this one. It's on Atlantic, super clean. And the last one is by Jermaine Jackson, Feel the Fire. Just a pristine example in The Shrink. The title track is probably the only track that I really enjoy. For $1, I wasn't going to pass this one up. I went to the Antiques Mall. Found a bunch of cheapies in really good shape. This one was $2. It's the Dave Brubeck Quartet. Brandenburg Gate Revisited. Super clean. And a Columbia 2i. Just beautiful. Huge Brubeck fan. Have so many of his titles. I'd be curious to know how many albums he released in his career. Just very prolific. This one was $2 as well. First Impression by The Impressions. Most of these songs were composed by Ed Townsend. Really great songwriter. And this is on the Kirk Tom label. Just love that label. This is mid-70s, so it's touch and go, but there are a couple good tracks on this one. Just in really nice condition. This was really weird. This was $1. This was a homemade self-released project, Naughty and Nice. It's autographed by the band. I don't know if I would have really gone with that image for the cover, but to each his own. And they put some money into this recording because the sound quality is really good. So side A consists of covers, Desperado by the Eagles, Trilogy. My favorite rendition of that is by Elvis from Aloha from Hawaii. I just love that song, Falling in Love, and then Words by the Bee Gees. And then side two, and that's the nice side. Side two is the naughty side. I think these are all self-penned songs. So strange. Knock, knock, Sit on My Face. Wishing I Was With Your Wife. The Asshole Song and Johnny Cash. So I looked this one up and it's actually worth about $12. Don't know who would really be interested, but again, when I see self-press albums, I always pick them up if they're a buck. You never know. Some are really good. This one, on the other hand, not so much. I paid $4 for this next title. This is an upgraded copy for myself. Happiness Is You. Just a pristine Columbia 2i stereo pressing. It says Wabash Cannonball on it. Not my favorite Cash album, but definitely worth the $4. I paid $5 for this one, Average White Band and Ben E. King. This is a beautiful copy in The Shrink with the price code and the hype. Of course, Get It Up for Love was the hit. They also do a cover of John Lennon's Imagine. Real nice job with that one. And this is on Atlantic. With the wrong inner sleeve. I purchased the rest of the titles from my friend. I was over his house last week. These were all $3 each. This one's actually still sealed. It's on that great label out of the UK, Charlie. Got to Get You Into My Life, Cliff Bennett and the Rebel Rousers. And boy, do they look like rebels. I don't know too much about this band. Of course, we know that classic. I think their other minor hit was One Way Love. I believe Brian Epstein, the Beatles manager, came across these guys at the Star Club in Germany and offered to manage them. I don't know how long they were around. A few nice covers on this album. They do cover the Beatles' Back in the USSR. Let's see, what else? It's All Right, some rock and roll classics, CC Rider Blues, Hold On, I'm Coming. Let's see, Barefootin', really nice album. I'm not a big collector of Elvis. Really purchased these for the covers. These aren't pressings that I see every day. I think these are all out of the UK as well, on Camden or maybe Pickwick International. Elvis the Legend, and this one's sealed. Great picture of Elvis on his classic Lincoln Continental there. Just a great shot of the black and white photo on the back as well. Pictures of Elvis. Again, this is a very nice RCA label out of the UK. Suspicious Minds. On the Camden label. And then this last one is still sealed. Are You Lonesome Tonight? Probably one of my favorite Elvis Presley ballads. There's a lot of great classics. Blue Hawaii, Hard-Headed Woman, Can't Help Falling in Love, Surrender, it's great stuff. The next one is by the Barquets, Propositions. This was just, again, just okay, kind of mediocre. I listened to it, nothing really stood out. This was from 1982. Next one is by Ruben Blades, Nothing But the Truth. And this is a promo. The only reason I purchased this album was for this. Elektra promos from this time period were put on this high quality audiophile vinyl, and they sound terrific. Every pressing that I've purchased on this compound has sounded great. Dead quiet vinyl, well, vinyl flat as can be, but that was usually the case. Anyway, listen to this. Not a stellar album, but just sounded great. An enjoyable listen. The last three albums are by the Blasters. Just a great kind of rockabilly outfit. Their saxophonist, or one of their saxophonists, Lee Allen. Major, major artist. Quite a bit older than the band. Lee played on all of the great early rock and roll recordings. With Little Richard on all of Richard's classics he's heard. Played with Fats Domino. The Stray Cats recruited him to play on their albums. He toured with the Rolling Stones. Just a very significant talent. Just a great player. These guys were smart to recruit him out of retirement. There's another great picture of him. I just have a tremendous love for that man. Just contributed so much to all of those rock and roll classics. Where each great rock and roll song had a great sax solo. Just a great guy. This one's self-titled. It's nonfiction. Lee was not on this album. This is Hardline. Still, all three of these albums are great. If you like the Stray Cats, you'll enjoy these albums. And I believe they're all on Slash. All three of these albums look like they have never been played. They're just pristine. All right. That's all I have. Thanks again for tuning in. Stay safe.